Hey yo, welcome back to Battlefield everyone. I'm your host Monk and we're playing some Ashes on Ashteki Online. So I'm about to go against Carl, new math on Ashteki. So I'm gonna play a little with Remia. So I just got done with Team Covenant League, which I just had a great match with Apple Sith. So thank you so much for that game, man. But I'm ready to go. Ready for some AIL action. Just catching up on the few games. I don't know if I'm going to play. I can't. This is going to be a horrible match. I don't know if I'm gonna be playing the AIL or play all the AIL and put them on YouTube or not. But most likely, just kind of keep it going. I could start doing the team coming in real matches as well over webcams. Comments below if you want that. But I'm gonna just continue on with the Ashes content. So here's the list. Which I'll post in the Ashes Discord after this. But I don't know. We want to both concede now. May take 2 hours. But I chose to go with Remia. I've been kind of fooling around with the deck ever since he got brought up on the Ashteki board. But it looks fun. But the funny thing is Crow is bringing his own version, which I honestly, I don't know what to really do this. Get all honest. I don't know if I want to, I probably will put 3-Eyed here because I don't know if he's going to use Law of Fear. I like Law of Fear here because it would exhaust the 3-Eyed Owl. Or I can do Call Upon the Realms just to make sure and guarantee I have the dice. I have not been like rolling the best on here at all. It's like a freaking Star Wars Destiny game. You play on TTS, man. Freaking. Sometimes you just have those days that you just hitting. Oh, I forgot to change this. Because I wanted more redirects on here, so I can get the dubs or that you got out. Versus figures, but we'll see. But it kind of looks like we have the same dice-ish, other than my time die that I have in here. I have the time die in there for generosity, just in case, as well as collect or recollect, just to bring back my stuff. Yep, I think I'm gonna have to do that. Oh. He got the best. Alright, good. I'm kind of glad I didn't go with calls this time. Want to use guardian cards? Nope. And he's choosing to go first. Well, good luck, man. Do the best. So, intimidation factor is a little bit much. You know, when you start going against Ash's vet, just like Carl, I've played against him a lot. This is going to be very interesting because we're going to be able to utilize the Remia's vision side action, which is look at the top 3 cards of a target's draw pile. So we'll keep looking at each other's decks, rearranging them the way we see fit, and then kind of going from there. I don't even know how to really attack this, to be honest. Hey, Bubba. Oh. Sounds good, baby. Love you. So yeah, we're just gonna be going back and forth with this, which is crazy. So I'm gonna visions his again because he just did his own. Oh. Okay. Why? All right. So he might be doing abundance too, just because he knew I was going to do an abundance thing at least. But I don't know. But it would be great for me to make sure that he doesn't get someone orchid doves at all. So I'll put heal, and then I'll put orchid dove on top and cancel. Right out. Alright, so let's see if he's gonna law my Dread Owl. I'll let him make the first move on that though. I'll put out a purge to get this freaking book out of the way. There's no way for him to draw right now. Purge is something that I don't really usually play. And yeah, I chose to do this because I feel like you need a kind of second push to mill. In the format of this deck. Biggest portion about Mia that I really like is, of course, the one or two extra health compared to what I'm usually used. The five spell board is amazing, especially on mill decks or all decks at that capacity. I'm pretty sure he was not expecting Purge at all. And the fact that I just replayed his stuff around. So now this is going to make me stall a little bit here, so I'm going to have to Law of Fear his owl. Don't have to worry about that. And then again, Vision is okay, dealt back on. Because he's going to Vision it back over so he doesn't draw the Orchid Dove book. If you don't know about Orchid Dove, right when we run out of cards, then we're kind of screwed. Because then the Orchid Dove books can start going crazy. Alright, so I gotta purge that away. Definitely purge that away. He can go ahead and draw those other two, that's fine with me. I gotta start looking at mine. Oh, that's pretty. I'll let him abundance me. Oh my God. Really? I can't. Oh my gosh. All right. Mine, see what he did. So he's going to go ahead and do that and bring it back here. My biggest thing for this is if I end up getting Recollect, then that's fantastic for me. I'll try to do this, even though he's going to. I should do this to myself. Just so I can bury the purge into the bottom of the deck. I didn't look at the last card that he had underneath top two. So I don't know what he could. I'll abundance it. All the two cards. Now you can get rid of mine. fact that he doesn't have the dice 2 purge or anything like that either. So now I really got to play around this a little bit for him to run into. So I really want to. Alright, and meteors. So this whole hand. Honest. I will play the second person. It's no. Overwhelm on roll. Attack. Oh, I don't want to tell them. So Mamiya has that nice little action of looking at the top three cards of a draw pile, and then you can rearrange them any way you want. And then if you exhaust Mamiya at all, then you can move whatever the uppermost card that you have that you put on top of that person's deck, mine or the opponent's. You can put it all the way down to the bottom if it's like a very valuable card. Doing a mine or his? I'm gonna go ahead and look at. There's abundance, so I definitely. Direct him. So that's the biggest reason why I started putting call in this deck, because this first round is brutal, especially the way I've been rolling as of late on Azteki. Call is just a needed item. Also gives you an extra main action. Wait your opponent out. But this is not a real good sign for Carl at all, both in abundance and dead. He doesn't have Essence Druid, because there's no sympathy die, the green die, to bring it back. And there's no Recollect, because there's no time die. So I'm trying to see what he's decided to supplement that. Oh! That's rough. That's rough, rough, rough. So that being said, to me, it would help if I pay attention to my own thing. I need abundance for sure. I need abundance to close this out, but as long as I get Recollect, I should be fine. I should have him, I should make him play. I got 24 cards left, he has 22. So I should make him play, I should make him play the off here. Honestly, the smart thing probably would have been put out Orchid Dub Book first and kill that. I know he has a heal in his hand. Also, too. He keeps looking at the top of his deck. Put out Orchid Dub Book. I honestly do not need the doors, but in this matchup, I have to utilize them as much as possible, or at least keep them in hand. It gives me some dried owl fodder. This first round was wild. Credit pass. Both of those. I do want to see. Run a memory drain him. To the top. Of my deck. Let's see what he's rid of. Honestly, he's rid of calls. Yeah, he can get rid of calls. Get rid of a heal. And it doesn't. Detrimental cards. He has 20 what cards left. I have. Alright, let's go opponents. Ooh, that is nice. Okay. Okay, man. Let's go ahead and purge here. Go ahead and purge that. Oh. Probably should have got rid of the name. Go to no blessing deck. Pretty spicy. Yep, gonna look at mine and probably do a purge on. If it's Orchid Dub book, I really hope Orchid Dub. Put something really spicy in it. Purge. Get his stuff again. Oh, I necessarily don't care about those. So I'm really looking at those at the other books, which but the biggest portion of it is both abundant. Got one Orchid Dove off of me. I got 22 cards, yes. question. Now I get to look at a couple more cards. I'm really hopeful I can get another book out. So there's no more of that as long as I get another Orchid Dove book. Really happy. So call being a thing. So let's go ahead and
kneeling.
All the kneel. Alright, I will happily. Don't need any of that stuff to go on the bottom. Kind of waiting it out here. The main action something. I'll do call here. This is such an interesting matchup. We both only have, again, a battlefield of 4. So Blessing being in that deck is a little interesting. Double Orchid Dove buff. Now let's go ahead and look at mine. Heal. Okay, cool. I'll probably Orchid Dove here. Action. I'm pretty sure he has Meteors and stuff like that in his deck. I really need Recollect. Recollect would be get these Orchid Dove books right out of them. He just looks at it, he's like, heal, ugh. So weird. Alright, he passes his alright, I'm gonna play it. Plays it, then I'll play mine. Heals and I got one generosity left. That's exciting. What, two health is gone? Oh, you go. Because that then allows him. Oh, right off the top of his deck. Yeah, I think it's all refresh. Of the give kids.
Oh, that's...
Oh, you just get. Mine. Not really one of them. All the way. Not at all. So that is a nice dynamic, but as long as you're able to heal it off, he already lost 2 heals. He might have generosity. Get rid of call. Sure. Oh, yeah. Alright, so let's go ahead and look at his. Didn't get any. Got. I forgot. I got the safe card. Got 3 heals now. That's really good for us. I got 18. He has 16. I got 2 cards up. I should purge here. Just to get out. He has first round. All right, go ahead and do that. Go ahead and get rid of that. Both meals gone. All meals gone. There's a meal. Side action. Down to now 14. Veracity coming in. Purge. He's gonna have to abundance real quick. He does have purge. Very ocean, they're not. That was dumb of me. Ended purge. Oh, he has to meditate though. Has generosity. Right. He knows now that he's abundant. Who are you looking at? You're looking at mine. Neil, generosity. Yeah, the generosity. I was gonna get both of those. All right. So let's go ahead and get this. I think ask it all. Okay. All right. You want to be able to pull off here. Bar. That's funny. I care about the Orca Dove. All. He's probably gonna see how the Orca Dove look or recollect. Nobody get the perspective. That really sucks for me. So that means I really don't have the other week. But I have 8 to do it. Looking. Yep. No. That's fine. Get everything done. Let them at hand. But the biggest factor was that's the one that really does. Well, honestly, I really don't know what the what left in it. Now it's just us gonna battle Red Owls here. Guard. Now Ramia's visions. That action doesn't really do anything. I'm pretty sure I don't need figures. Out of bed. Oh, that would have been funny. Wow. About that. And now it turns off purge, really. Purge is just ascension. Want to get another milk. I don't have double Orca Dove book at all, so I really need it. Orca Dove that's turned off. Just, all upon the room. Direct. Sure. I don't know. I'm pretty sure I don't need meat anymore. So he doesn't have a good book. Of abundance. I'm not 3-eyed just so I can use it. and Rossi's gonna have some plays. I think he has two more, possibly two capacity. Plays one up here. Have one more up here in it. I'll throw another card gone. Still counted for the Red Owls. I'll bun it. Gonna fill his need. Okay. One for one. Just use me on his. He has one heal on it. Doesn't have a snake, so he can work in there. So the good thing about him doing what he did is now he still has an owl on the board. Start a next round and it's going to be my action. We can just go ahead and get rid of whatever I have in my hand. Right off the bat. I'm going to summon an orchid though. He has remorse still in his hand, I think. Yeah, I'm pretty sure he has a couple more in his hand. Oh, he's going to wait for me to attack him. I probably should not attack. But I'll just use that as a blocker if he has another blessing. That light thing. Oh, you're making me attack. Sure, I'll use a Defend Death Star on that. Back. Oh, I didn't attack. My bad. This guy. Hit it again. One more time. I know how to play Ashes, everybody. Boom. Use that card. Use Remorse. I just realized I completely forgot about Wapi. Did that earlier in the game today. Smart. Be smart. Yeah, that was dumb. He just blocked just for funsies. Because you know he can't attack the Lightbringer. He's just gonna pass main. I should just pass main too. Switch it up. I'll keep that just in case. Just for generosity's sake. No. He's gonna get ahead on the three-eyed owl game. And is that okay? Pretty sure that's okay, to be honest. Pretty sure he has one more Law of Fear to do. So he can Law of Fear out. Oh yeah, I can always do that too. Be smart again. Oh, I might as well do this. Clear out a board. What he does. Is that remorse? And 2 damage to me. Voice. Enter. Alright. Attack me for 2. Bring in that heat back. Alright. Okay. I'm going to turn down these. Then abundance. I'm doing that to prevent the redirect if you happen to have any. Now we're just going to abundance back and forth here. Yeah, I was unlucky for that first roll. On that first roll, he rolled how many blanks? Or how many generics? 5 basics. So 5 basics is rough. Anything above 4, it's real rough. Choose a card, discard. Let's get rid of that call. Go ahead and send an Orca Dove. We're going to go ahead and meditate the purge. That. Got another remorse in there, man? Guess I have another generosity here. There you go. Just heal just in case. You do well played, girl. Very well, tough man. Jeez. That was truly rough. Was. Great game, man. Holy crap. Yeah, losing both books and the 5 dice. It was rough. 5 dice generics. 6. Hard start for sure. That's why I use the calls. Just in case. Double purge abundance on the other side. You're right there. right there. Remorse, I really thought about tooling into my deck too. Thank you for the game. Thank you for the game, man. Well, at least hopefully you can hear this or watch this later on. See my viewpoints of everything. But yeah, starting from that round one, getting double purge off was pretty detrimental. And me being able to complete the abundance Exodia for the most part, especially with Ramia's aftermath and his own purge on his side, was pretty crazy. But a freaking crazy game made it me like really think way too extensively about this damn game. But I absolutely love how deep and how awesome this game really becomes. Especially when we get this type of dynamic. And again, like, you don't really see mill or stall decks really in the meta inside this. So don't, like, if you watch my videos and you see that I keep playing this type of deck, it's just because that's what fits to me. That's what I jive with. And I really like testing other waters or testing people's waters regarding it. But I'm just excited to see that you're able to go through and, you know, dive deep into these type of versions of certain decks, and the fact that you can make Ramia an ultimate attacky deck person, or you can make any Phoenixborn whatever you want it to make. I have like 8 different Phoenixborns with this type of same dynamic, but of course has their own niches for each one. But it just really depends. But this one is a really interesting one, and I'm pretty damn intrigued on how well this somewhat did. I do have an updated version of this deck, which I didn't even upload yet, which I put in more redirects, and took out one of the one or two or both of the figures, just to kind of accompany another generosity and that stuff, I think, if I'm not mistaken. But in either case, thank you so much for tuning in, guys. It truly is appreciated. I hope you guys enjoy this Ashes content. If you did, please like the video as well as leave a comment below. Tell me what you liked about it, what you thought about the match. Let Carl know that he's still the best, and like I am the worst for always trying to invent these type of decks. And all is fast. Thank you so much, guys. Catch you later. Peace.